नमस्कार। इंडिया मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट वेलकम्स यू इन इट्स डेली वेदर ब्रीफिंग। इन दिस वेदर ब्रीफिंग वी विल फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सी सिनॉप्टिक सिचुएशन सिनॉप्टिक सिस्टम्स ओवर द कंट्री एंड देयर फोरकास्ट फॉर नेक्स्ट 5 डेज एंड देन वी विल कम ओवर टू मॉनसून एक्टिविटी ओवर द कंट्री ड्यूरिंग पास्ट 24 आवर्स एंड आफ्टर दैट वी विल कम ओवर टू वेदर वार्निंग ओवर द कंट्री फॉर नेक्स्ट 5 डेज। So as far as synoptic systems are concerned, so as per India Meteorological Department's prediction based on numerical weather prediction models, the eastern end of the monsoon trough has shifted southwards, although the western end is running along the foothills of Himalayas. The eastern end is now passing through Beharaich, Patna, Giridih of Jharkhand, Digha of West Bengal, and then southeast was to North Bay of Bengal. This eastern end of the monsoon trough is very likely to remain south of its normal position during next 4 or 5 days, and the western end is likely to shift southwards from the foothills of Himalayas from tomorrow. And there is a cyclonic circulation over northwest Bay of Bengal extending up to 3.1 kilometer above mean sea level, and under the influence of this cyclonic circulation, a low pressure area is very likely to form by tomorrow, 28th of August, over northwest and adjoining west central Bay of Bengal. And this low pressure area under the influence of its subsequent movement across the central parts of the country, this active monsoon conditions are very likely over central India and West India. So and another there is important system which is going to cause severe weather, which is going to cause intense rainfall spell over coastal and South India, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu during next 2-3 days, is a shear zone which is running between 4.5 and 7.6 kilometer above mean sea level and roughly along latitude 13 degree north. And we can see in this adjoining satellite picture that this sisar, under the influence of this sisar over northwest Bay of Bengal, there is intense to very intense convection over west central Bay of Bengal and adjoining northwest Bay of Bengal. So as far as rainfall activity over the country during past 24 hours is concerned, so very heavy rainfall has been observed over Uttarakhand, East Uttar Pradesh, Odisha, Bihar, Kerala and South India, Karnataka, and heavy rainfall has also been observed over many other subdivisions of the country. Maharajganj of East Uttar Pradesh and Tribeni of West Champaran have reported 16 centimeter of rainfall, and Shivamoga of Karnataka and Supaul of Bihar, Mussoorie and Kottayam has reported 13 centimeter of rainfall. So under the influence of these rainfall activities, the monsoon has remained active. The monsoonal rainfall has remained more than 1.5 times up to 4 times of the normal rainfall, of the average rainfall, over Arunachal Pradesh, Assam and Meghalaya, West Bengal and Sikkim, Bihar and Telangana. Whereas given the very active to vigorous monsoon conditions over this Kerala, the monsoon has remained vigorous over Kerala and Mahe. And over rest parts of the southern peninsular India and this eastern coast, that is Odisha and Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, and when we come over to western Himalayan region, our Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand and East UP have experienced normal monsoon conditions. That is the monsoonal rainfall between 1.5 times to minus 1.5 times of average rainfall. And over rest parts of the country, over western India, over central India, and this over Punjab, Haryana, West UP, and Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh, Gilgit, Baltistan, and Muzaffarabad, the monsoon has remained weak. So now we come over to weather warning for next 5 days. So as far as this our monsoonal rainfall activity over Northeast India is concerned, so yesterday Northeast India had experienced isolated extremely heavy rainfall. Today it has reported isolated heavy to very heavy rainfall, and as there a low cyclonic circulation has formed extending up to mid tropospheric levels over Northwest Bay of Bengal. So this rainfall activity intensity of the rainfall activity over Northeast India is very likely to decrease, although heavy to very heavy rainfall at isolated places very likely during next 24 hours, and after that this rainfall activity is likely to reduce to only isolated heavy rainfall on 28th, and on 29th there will be further reduction, and from 30th onwards, 30th August onwards, there is no heavy rainfall likelihood over Northeast India. And as far as this East UP and Uttarakhand are concerned, isolated heavy to very heavy rainfall is likely during next 24 hours, and then this rainfall activity is also likely to reduce to isolated heavy rainfall. And as far as this our Sisar is concerned over Northwest Bay of Bengal, so under its influence a low pressure area formation is likely by tomorrow. Then this our new rainfall belt is going to be from Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana to passing up to South Madhya Pradesh, then Vidarbha, Marathwada, Madhya Maharashtra, northern parts of Madhya Maharashtra, northern parts of Konkan, and South Gujarat region, and this our southwest Madhya Pradesh. So we can see that heavy rainfall warning is there for Telangana, Rayalaseema and CAP today, and which is likely to continue tomorrow as well. And then this heavy rainfall probability is there over Vidarbha on 29th of August. Then over on 30th of August, heavy rainfall probability is there over Vidarbha and Marathwada. And then on 31st of August, there is heavy rainfall probability over our this northern parts of Madhya Maharashtra, North Konkan, and this South Gujarat, and southern parts of Madhya Pradesh. So now once this low pressure area forms and the numerical weather prediction models give more clear picture, our weather warning, our rainfall warnings would be amended, would be updated and upgraded accordingly. So as far as this one more major system, as I have discussed, this shear zone roughly along 13 degree north. So under the influence of this shear zone, isolated heavy to very heavy rainfall is very likely over southern parts of peninsular India. Isolated heavy rainfall is likely over south and coastal south interior and coastal Karnataka and Rayalaseema, and isolated heavy to very heavy rainfall is likely over Kerala and Tamil Nadu during next 24 hours, and after that on 28th and 29th of August, isolated heavy to very heavy rainfall with isolated extremely heavy falls is likely over Kerala and Ghat areas of Tamil Nadu. So that is our main hotspot for southern South India during next two three days. And on day 4, that is on 30th of August, this rainfall activity over Kerala and Tamil Nadu would reduce to just isolated heavy rainfall. And from 31st of August, there is no heavy rainfall warning for our this southern peninsular India. So and as far as this our Northwest India is considered, so under the influence of southward shifting of the western end of the monsoon trough, the light to moderate rainfall activity with the isolated to scattered rainfall would begin from 29th of August. And on 27th and 28th of August, there may be slight drizzles over the plains of Northwest India, that is over our Rajasthan, Haryana, Punjab, West UP. But from 29th, there will be light to moderate rain over all these areas. And as far as our this Delhi NCR region is concerned, so partly cloudy sky would be there on today and tomorrow, and then very light rainfall activity, as we have just discussed, that once the western end of the monsoon trough shifts southwards from the foothills of Himalayas, then very light rainfall probability would be there on 29th of August, and then 30th and 31st August there will be probability of light rainfall, and then from 1st and 1st September it would be reducing to just very light rainfall or just drizzles. So that's all for today. Tomorrow we will again meet with our daily weather briefing for next 5 days. Please visit our website mausam.imd.gov.in and our Facebook and Twitter handles. Also use our apps, Mausam app, Damini app, and Meghdoot app for location specific warnings, for lightning alert, and for agro advisory services. So that's all for today. Tomorrow we will again meet with the weather warning for next 5 days. So thank you very much and goodbye.